Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 59 of the Realm Recap. I am Jason from YakFace.com, joined as always by FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net.
Good evening, pre-celebration fans out there in the interwebs. I can't believe we're going to be there next week, this time. Wow.
Just a few short days. It's kind of surreal at this point. We were on the Wolfpack podcast last night. And you could obviously tell those guys are super hyped up about going, and they're prepping, they're getting ready to go as we speak, I think. So
it's like Christmas on steroids. It's kind of like,
it's going to be fun. That show hasn't been posted live yet since there's some, it was a Skype call this time with, we had, Jonah Marie from, Blue Jay Guys on Twitter. She's part of the, she does contribution stuff with making StarWars.net and the Wookiee Gunner, lots of stuff. So it was a good chat with her last night and got to talk a lot about Clone Wars and a lot about Clone
Captain
Wars.
Rex.
Captain Rex and stuff like that. So anyway, with this week's show, is pretty loaded considering all of the exclusive news, not all, but a majority, I would say, of the exclusive news kind of dropped out this week regarding stuff that's going to be available at Celebration and a fair amount of Hasbro stuff and whatnot. So we will start as always with the Kenner and Hasbro portion. I'm wishful thinking, I guess.
Well, that is some Kenner Celebration kind of stuff. So
yeah,
but this is one that you and I knew about for a long time, just a little rumor, but couldn't quite put it together.
Right. So, we were kind of, we had talked about the contents and stuff before, but this is actual visual proof that this is in existence at some level. I don't know if the Jabba's Rancor pit it's supposed to be coming as a Toys R Us exclusive. The box that they're showing there, it clearly does have that Toys R Us sticker on it. Mm-hmm. I sent off a few emails to Hasbro and their Hunter PR to get some clarification on this, and I haven't received anything yet. So sure. I assume there's going to be some sort of a reveal on this.
Yep.
Maybe at Celebration. I'm not sure how, considering Hasbro doesn't have a panel. But
well, I did pick up today online on the tweets on the Twitter that Hasbro had confirmed. There's a San Diego Comic-Con exclusive coming along. And actually, thinking about it later on today, I thought, this actually could fit the bill. It's Toys R Us. But then again, they've done that before, having it at San Diego Comic-Con, so...
Right, a joint exclusive type thing.
Yeah, kind of thing going on, but...
who knows?
We're getting a repacked Rancor, which is a great figure.
Yep.
With a lot of other repacked figures and...
Yeah, the Gamorrean Guard, which has been a popular figure throughout the run of the Vintage Collection. The Luke, most recently, that figure was released as part of the that deleted scene wave that came out towards the end of the Vintage Collection run. Again, you have Slave Leia in there, and the C-3PO, which is a pretty well-desired figure. I mean, that was an initial launch kind of release of the Vintage Collection line.
That's right.
And then the question is about that Jabba, though. Jedi Temple Archives had shared this image initially. Well, they had shared this Facebook post that we're sharing here. Paul, with the eye for detail that he has, he noticed that it looks a lot different than any other previous 3¾-inch Jabba that's come out prior. And it almost looks like a scaled down version of the 6-inch Jabba that we've received, in the in the Black Series line, as well as the San Diego exclusives. So that was the main question I had for Hasbro, is what is actually new or whatnot in this box, because it does that Jabba does look to be
retooled new or something.
Yeah,
it's a big ass set, man. This is a big, big set.
Yeah,
I'm guessing
lots of clear plastic there to
damage,
get crushed.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Strange releases, but it's different as well from, I mean, we can't really see from this, but the ATST pack, did that not come with a background diorama from memory? It did, didn't it? The,
yes, it did. Yep.
So this one doesn't appear from this photograph to have any. But
it's hard to tell with this because of the glare on the box, and you know it's a dark dungeon anyway. You know, below the pit, there might be some rock walls there or something. But anyway,
so what do you think? I mean, I'm guessing around the $100 mark to start off with.
Well, that, you know, the ATST version that was exclusive to Toys R Us last year, that was around that $100 price range, and this has got, you know, some bigger stuff in it, you know, as far as the Rancor, the Jabba, and then the five figures or four figures, I guess. I wouldn't doubt it being $100 or more.
Yeah. Definitely.
You know, 119, you know, one, you know, something around there. But who knows? That's kind of what I'm looking for, some sort of a confirmation, like I said, from Hasbro as far as price, availability, you know, contents and whatnot. So
yeah, that was literally August last year. We knew about that. We were talking about it privately.
Yep.
But yeah, I mean, that's been a long time. so it shows you shuffling around the release dates of things, and because it was planned at 1.4 last year. So
right.
There we go. So interesting.
I assume we'll see it before the year is out. I would guess because of, you know, in that box there, it's probably ready to go. It could be like a May the 4th type of release.
Yep.
So
stay tuned.
We'll see. Next up here, I've kind of dubbed this Scale Wars. We had talked about this, I think, previously, maybe on last week's show even, but there was some images going around of weird scale issues with the 3¾-inch Black Series line. If we're sharing this image here that showed up in the Rebel Scum forums, this is an image of the new Commander Wolf that's coming out, Commander Doom in the middle, and Captain Rex, obviously, on the far right. And there's an obvious scale issue from one figure to the other. It's really weird. Really weird.
It is definitely weird. It's, but I mean, this again comes from using different clone bodies. I mean, this wolf is incredibly compressed. That torso is tiny.
Right. That's an all new figure, so there's not any recycling really going on there. The Doom in the middle looks to be recycling some components, but again, it's half, you know, it's in between the wolf and the Rex as far as the scale.
It does look just a little weird.
Yeah, it's odd for, you know, for figures that are supposed to be clones to have that drastic of a drop off. I mean, that wolf, I mean, if you taking in consideration photography, you don't really know, you know, how exaggerated this is. I think Paul again had shared some images on his Jedi Temple Archives, you know, with some figures back to back, which shows better the discrepancy in the scale.
Yep.
But that wolf compared to Rex looks at least a half inch shorter.
It really does.
And the, you know, the head is just microscopic almost compared to the figures. So it's really weird what Hasbro's doing here. I think a lot of people, at least from fan sites anyway, are going to be asking Hasbro at Celebration, what's going on with the scale, and is there, you know, a new team involved here, or what's the deal? So,
well, we had that problem before way back, and just as we're talking about the Vintage Collection 3PO, which when it came out, we were all a little concerned that it was too short.
Right.
And Hasbro's response at the time, if I remember the Q&A report, was that when they go through the process, there is a sentiment of shrinkage from the mold that they expect. So, I guess Wolf just got some serious shrinking, but
poor guy.
Yeah, poor guy. So, never mind.
And that brings us to another one here, too, is the Leia Boosh and Slave Leia comparison. That's pretty drastic as well.
Well, I mean, I'm just opening the image here just now, but we'll... I had a conversation with a few people on it. I'm not quite so sure it's such a major issue, this one, for me, but we'll just wait for this image to pull up here. Some people are not happy about this at all.
Right.
Come on, internets. So basically what the picture is, once if you're listening to the audio or you're just waiting for this to pull up, it's a 6-inch Bush Bounty Hunter and 6-inch Slave Leia comparison. And this image just does not seem to load. Anyway, it's considerably shorter. Let me see if I've got another. No, scale. Can we? There we go. There we go. So yeah,
The
figure is bad when you see it there.
A half inch shorter again, at least. You know, and this, it's Leia comparing against another Leia. You know, you would think they should be relatively the same size.
Well, I mean, there's heels on those boots, so even just in the line for a little bit of, yeah, I suppose it is a little odd.
I mean,
it?
Like, compare waist to where, you know.
Yep.
It's just odd. I mean, that doesn't take away from the sculpt of either figure as far as, you know, if you're not having them side by side, let's say, you know, Leia and Boosh, there's no way I would not buy that figure.
Yep.
Just, it's incredible from a sculpt and detail paint standpoint. There's, you know, there's nothing to complain about on a figure level. You know, there's nothing all that wrong about Leia too. You know, it's hard with a figure that's as scantily clad as she is to hide a lot of the articulation points. So, you know, you get to see all of the joints and whatnot, but, you know, as separate figures, they're great. But side by side, it just looks really, it's jarring as far as the comparison. You know, the hands are extremely different between one another as far as scale.
Yeah, it's Leia's
head size.
Leia's butch sister compared to the other one, yeah. But again, I mean, look, for me, $20 toy, I'm not going to be standing them together to compare them that way.
Right.
Not a showstopper, I think, but yeah, some people.
No, not at all.
Irate about it, but yeah. Look, these things are going to happen, I think, when you manufacture thousands and thousands of toys. So, yeah. I hope Hasbro can maybe tell us a little bit more from some of the questions and interviews that and others have with them at Celebration. Maybe we can find it a little bit more.
Right. This last bit of Hasbro news for the week. Kind of been waiting for this item for a while now. This is the last of the known exclusives, anyway, for Target for the Rebels line. This is the ATDP with the driver. Jedi Temple Archives had shared this article, an image that this was found in California. So, at Target, I believe. Well, it's obvious because it's an exclusive there. There's nothing new here as far as I'm concerned. I'll have to see once I get it if there's any paint differentiation between the loose figure that's packed in versus the individually carded one.
I thought you'd done a comparison between these two, or someone had at one point. One was slightly darker. Am I thinking of a different thing?
It kind of varies depending on photography that's out there. By all looks of it, it looks to be the same kind of dark toned version of the ATDP driver that we've received so far. So.
Yep. Well.
But like I said, I'm looking to get this to see if there's any differentiation because, like, even with that Inquisitor that comes with the TIE fighter. There are two different paint variations for that figure as well. Even packed in the Target exclusive, you know, we shared a couple shows ago that there was the different deco on the face sculpt for the Inquisitor. You could get that. You could get both versions in the vehicle pack in as well. So, who knows?
Variant hunters, off you go.
Right. Moving on to Sideshow Hot Toys and other goodies manufacturers for the week. Not a lot of news there, but I think it's SMS. Is that the name of the audio company? They have a new series of the Star Wars themed headphones.
These are cool.
Yeah.
Very cool. I had not seen these before. Quite surprised.
Yeah, there's a Vader a TIE fighter, Chewbacca, and C-3PO. As those are all part of the second edition.
I love the Chewy ones. It's just so retro, that brown color. It's fantastic.
They do.
Looks great. Even the kind of tarnish on the R2 unit there is looking good as well.
Yeah.
Very slick. Very, very slick. Not sure about the audio quality of SMS. Not really knowing them too much, but yeah. Free t-shirt as well with a pre-order.
I think this is the company that 50 Cent owns.
50?
So.
Ah, yes. I think you're right. Yeah. Collapsible. Oh, there we go. There's a little pack shot there as well.
Yes, I mean, great presentation as far as from a packaging and packaging standpoint. I've heard that the quality is really good on these. These aren't wireless headphones. These are, you know, you need these plug are a wired phone. Deal. But yeah,
they look pretty nifty. Like
pretty
them.
Nice.
They are pretty nice, even at $200. And there's your free t-shirt. Very cool.
Yep. Let's see what else. Hot Wheels. We seem to get around to Hot Wheels like every other show, but Hot Wheels does have new cars coming as far as in the character car line. I was kind of snooping around on the Hot Wheels site and found an article and some new imagery for some individual cars that are coming out. C-3PO, which is the shiny version of the battle damage one that was included in the 2-pack.
Excellent.
There's an Inquisitor car, which we've kind of known about for a while. Mm-hmm. I think that was shown at San Diego or Toy Fair, but this is available. There's some new 2-packs coming out. There's a Obi-Wan and a redeco of the Darth Vader car that's supposedly Episode 4 colorations. I'm not sure.
Wow. Excellent.
And then there's a second set that they didn't have imagery for. There was a 501st clone trooper and a battle droid car, and that car is an exclusive to that.
Excellent. Keeping this line going. I'm surprised there maybe not something for them at Celebration. Or the R2 KT. That's right. I'll talk about that later on. Cool.
Very neat. And if people are hunting those down, you could go to. It seems like they've kind of been pushing these early at Kmart. That's what the Hot Wheels site has said. So, people I think are still looking for the Boba Fett car as well as the Chopper car. You might be able to score those at Kmart.
Very cool.
Sideshow. There's a little bit of Sideshow news here. They haven't announced an exclusive for Celebration. It's kind of surprising. I was kind of hoping or betting on that we'd get some sort of an exclusive clone. You know, could be a Commander Doom or even a Commander Thorn. You know, kind of tying that Marvel
that would have been good
thing in. But they haven't announced anything. But they do have an on-site kind of project where they've called upon a bunch, like I think they said like 90 different artists to take their deluxe R2-D2 sixth scale figure and come up with, you know, artistic interpretations of that figure.
I think my favorite has to be this R2 on his side as an ATA. That's phenomenal. Very clever.
Yeah, they're very cool. For people that are following along, either through our YouTube channel or that listen to the audio, we'll have show notes taking you to their particular page here. But yeah, there are some great versions of R2 in there. I'd like to own one of these. I mean, there isn't any one that I wouldn't like.
No, they are all incredibly original and geez, they're just, yeah.
This is one that's a grill.
Strip the cheeseburgers on it. Yeah, these have to be seen. Definitely click these in the link in the show notes underneath the video. But Samurai R2,
yeah.
Beautiful. Lots of little details going on there. So yeah, very cool indeed. So that's a lot of Sideshow little R2 units that were hacked to death. So very cool.
Looking forward to seeing that. And finally, with the others and custom bits here. Blue Production, or was it Blue Boy Production? They had
Blue Boy
Blue Ghost Production.
Blue Ghost Production.
Yeah, they had posted another teaser of their packaging shot for their upcoming Mini Wars figure of Boba Fett.
Yeah,
I kind of drooled
the
over that a little bit.
I know. The clear perspex in the box, it rings, just gets so much attention to detail. And there's an outer sleeve as well. And these cool little blueprints go in the pack there. So such love, attention, and detail. And I think I can't quite see what that was in that picture. But it's a Boba Fett, some shape, size, or form, maybe a vintage one. Or maybe it's a Kubrick in a bag, I don't know. But he's getting lots of inspiration for Boba.
Yeah, see if it blows up a little. No. Hmm.
Yeah, definitely.
Looks like it might be a
Kubrick.
That's a vintage Kubrick.
Vintage Kubrick, just getting a kind of there's a Boba in the background there, so yeah. Good looking stuff. Can't wait for these things to come out soon.
Cool. Big fan.
Yes.
That brings us to a kind of a separate segment here that we're going to cover several of the Celebration exclusives that were announced since our last show. There are a ton. Some good, some better than others, but there's a wide range of stuff that's going to be available for sure. Starting with Gentle Giant, they announced their droids version of their jumbo C-3PO figure. Very cool for those that love, you know, vintage Kenner stuff. And it's one of those figures that you don't like. I never had one of the droids figures growing up as a kid, which is very odd, at least for me. but it's one of those exclusives that sometimes Gentle Giant will put out that you don't necessarily need to get in order to fill your, you know, vintage Kenner 12-inch line. You know, let's say this was a Royal Guard, let's say. You know, people would probably be more upset that this is an exclusive,
Correct.
Would be an exclusive than this figure. But for $100, it's not a bad offering. I'm not sure if did they share images of the card?
No, they certainly did not. They keep doing that. They kind of omit that sometimes, which is a bit of a pain. But
Rebel Scum had posted an image of that this week.
Did they?
So it's as you'd expect.
Somewhere.
Yeah, it's very, you know, indicative of what the original packaging was. And again, like the droids figures, they came with the coin, so that it comes with the gold coin. So.
Yeah, I already know a few people who really. I was not really for me, but a lot of people were like, "Oh, I can't wait to get that." So yeah, it struck a note with a lot of vintage, without a doubt.
Let's see. General Giant also announced another exclusive mini bust. This is the General McQuarrie, based off of Ralph McQuarrie, which is great. I mean, they seem to always around convention time have an exclusive McQuarrie themed mini bust.
Definitely.
And this is the one where Ralph McQuarrie has the cameo appearance in The Empire Strikes Back.
That's right.
So this is one I did order. Just because I love McQuarrie stuff. If I, you know, that doesn't necessarily mean I'll keep it, but I know someone here that locally in my Jedi Defender collector group that collects mini busts. So, and you to be able to pre-order some of this stuff early prior to Celebration, you need to be a Premier Guild member.
Yep.
And I am one, and he wasn't, so I just ordered it.
So at least someone can get it. Yep.
Yeah, because the pre-orders they sold out. So
yep.
They will have some of these on hand at Celebration if people are looking to pick those up without being a Premier Guild member. So. $120 is a lot. I'll give it that.
It is a lot. Busts seem to be less and less these days. They don't seem to be quite the kind of fashion, I guess you could say, that they were many years ago, but it's still nice to see them still coming out over time for those that want to collect them. So, yeah.
Let's see. Funko announced a ton of those damn Hikari Sofubi vinyl figures. They're promising, threatening one more that has yet to be announced for Celebration. But just the other day, they announced four. There was a patina, you know, black wash. I can't remember what they're calling it. A matte black, which doesn't look black in any way to me. I'm not sure why they called it that. Boba Fett. It looks very bronzish. I'm not sure.
It does. Yeah.
There's that. There is the Greedo, which is very cool.
It is. Nice portion, though. Yeah.
It's recycling the previous, you know, two versions that have come out so far, but this is kind of a, again, kind of a patina, chrome, bronzy wash to it, which I really like. Let's see. I'm not sure what the edition size on some of those. I know I posted it when I shared the article on Yakface, but it's they're very limited. 1,000, I think.
Greedo is one of 500. Boba is one of 1,000. The almost halfway stuck through the Star Trek teleporter, clone trooper, stormtrooper, sorry, is one of 750. And the, I don't know why, the glitter, I don't know what you would call him, glitter trooper is one of 1,000.
So. Yeah, they're calling the blue stormtrooper the icy stormtrooper.
Well, there you go.
Which is kind of icy trooper. Neat.
I mean, that's they could go on forever with these colors, and they will.
They will. So, and they're calling the clone trooper the Star Clone Trooper.
Star Clone Trooper. Okay. I call it glitter. So
I do too. It looks very glittery.
Glitter girl.
Disco ball.
Disco trooper. So yeah. So yeah. I mean, these. I mean, again, even if you're not a fan of them. These will sell out fast. So if you know somebody, you want to help somebody out, definitely collect them because, the scalpers will be out there as well. So
They'll be available for sale at Funko's booth. Booth 1410 is what it looks like there. So if you're compiling a list of stuff you want or stuff you may want in the future, you might want to jot them down because those will go fast if there's enough people interested. Another one that popped up here was a new plush figure from Underground Toys. They produce several different styles and price points of plush figures. They announced their electronic plush Max Rebo figure, which is kind of different. I mean, it's not something you expect. You know, it's him with his, the organ that he sits at, and it plays music from that scene, and it's the original music as well. It's not the special edition tune, I guess.
Whatever it was.
Yep.
Yeah. Very cool. Wow.
Different. If you're into plush, this is...
If you're into plush, yeah. If you're a plushie, every time I see him, I just think of the robot chicken. I'm not a blue elephant, or whatever it was called. Very cool.
The next one, I think, probably interests both of us. This is the Lego. I'm calling this the Lego Lars Homestead. I think it has a different name. I think they're calling it some sort of Tatooine set. But it clearly that's what it is. It's this leaked out on eBay. I had noticed that Groovebricks had shared this link.
Yep.
But it's a little box set that includes some tiny of those micro type figures.
That's right.
So it's got like two Jawas, Luke, C-3PO, R2-D2. It's got a full-size C-3PO. I'm not sure what's different about him, if anything. And then it includes a micro-scale Sandcrawler, which I love. Yep. And then there's a little Landspeeder in there. And then obviously the little Lars Homestead with moisture evaporators and little skeletons of... No, it doesn't have them.
I was going to say that little crispy Andrew and Lars. But
I want that so bad.
I do too, and I definitely want to get hold of this thing. These things go for silly money after the event. So
they're going for silly money now.
Yeah, no, $250 was what I saw literally the minute when I posted it. So our Groovebricks sent it to you and I. So
yeah
it's interesting. And there was some other Lego stuff that followed right on with that.
Yeah, some movie posters, which are kind of cool. These are available at their booth. They did six of them, one for each of the movie releases, episodes 1 through 6.
Yeah,
pretty cute.
They are indeed. So
I'm not sure what the size of these are. Do you know?
I do not know, no, I have no idea, but they sent us some incredibly high res. I just posted the high res ones if people want to get them, but yeah, they look really cool. I don't know if the, my brain is just frozen up in terms of the artist who I love and I can't remember. But yeah, it's in that same theme of all the posters that he's done, so a nice complete set. But the other one was printed on the back of it is the advertisement for the upcoming July series of Droid Tales.
Right.
So, which features Rebels in the background, which I just realized.
So, yeah, it's got Rebels, it's got, you know, Ewoks, and I'm not sure who is that.
I don't know
what character.
I don't know. It could be a mystery new character or something. They tend to maybe sometimes add new characters into the show, but clearly the timeline is all over the place here because we've got Luke and Leia. You know, older versions of them, I guess. Han and Chewie and the Rebels characters. And,
right.
Yeah, I don't know.
Does that C-3PO on the, you know, does he look different to you? Or is that typical?
I don't really see any difference at all. There's no printed arms. There's nothing.
Right.
No, we've had...
I don't know.
We've had one with printed legs, which I think came with a sandcrawler.
Right.
But prior to that, we hadn't. But otherwise, I mean, sometimes Lego just make minimal differences to it.
Mm-hmm.
But
shade of plastic difference or something.
Yeah, a little. Even this kind of, I think there's almost like little stains on his chest where the restraining bolts are, things like that. So it could be really minimal stuff. But yeah, mystery character coming in July. So even if you don't go to Celebration, you can still pick these up at the Lego shop.lego.com, I should say. During the May the 4th promotion, so you'll have to have a spend and you'll get a chance to get these posters, but thanks to LEGO PR for sending them along.
Nice. StarWars.com put up a sneak peek of some of the Celebration store exclusives. A lot of shirts, patches, bag, you know, just a bunch of different stuff. You know, a lot of the shirts, I think we talked about this a little bit last show, I thought. Maybe not.
But
might have been a different show.
Railscum did share the price list. I was looking at that through the week, but yeah, the I think there's still a lot more to be revealed.
Yeah,
this is unusual.
the Space Select Jack in the Box.
Yes,
I do like the blocks. To be honest, you know, I've got.
I do well. I do as well. They were pretty cool.
I got a couple, you know, toddlers here that would like those. You know, they don't care that it's Star Wars. I do, but they'll play with those, and I'd love to have them play with Star Wars blocks and learn Aerobash if they can. Or
it's called good parenting. That's it.
Yep.
So yes, is that a little watermark I see down at the bottom there? Is there some kind of
Rebel Scum sponsors the Celebration store for this celebration, so. They have their watermark on all of these images from the Celebration store.
So lots of t-shirts, those cool t-shirts. Socks, just in case you needed some Star Wars Celebration socks.
I don't.
No, I think I'll skip to. I have to say, I think some of these items, particularly the Space Slug in the box, might be worth waiting until the Sunday when they kind of normally discount some of the stuff. I can't see that selling very quickly, but you never know. But nice t-shirts. I like the Trooper t-shirt. Sorry, you were going to say?
This is kind of a preview. If you go to the StarWarsCelebration.com site, you'll be able to see more. They go in a little bit more in depth on availability on some of these. These pins are just going to be a bear to get all of them. You know, there are different criteria you need to meet for something like that Yoda one. I want that Yoda one so bad. You have to spend $130 to be able to get it, and that's ridiculous. I think
that is ridiculous. That's insane.
Right.
Why would you need to spend $130 to get a pin?
And there's also blind bag 2-packs that are not shown here.
Oh man,
so I'm not sure if those
carbonate.
And I need the Yak Face one, obviously, there on the bottom.
Obviously.
So.
Well, available through trade with staff. Well,
easy enough. But
it should be easy enough, but yeah.
Anyway.
So, geez, man. This is going to be tough.
Yeah. I hope you can buy. I hope it, you know, after the show, you can buy full sets. Because that doesn't mean I would actually buy it if they did offer it. But for the people that want to collect these, you know, much like the people that collect, you know, patches or badges or whatever, you know, to be able to offer up something like that.
Well,
would be really great.
You would have focus. I've got a Boba Fett focus, and you know, you're getting the bad end of the stick here because you're $130 just to get the
I know.
Order. What? Look, you're going to get it. I'm sure you will. I'm sure there'll be some way of trade or something. There'll be,
yeah.
I mean, there's always trade sessions, so.
Right. And the next little bit here, collecting track patch set. This was something we at Yakface have partnered with five other sites. Like we did with previous celebrations, a collectible patch set. This is one where we partnered with Jedi News, Jedi Business, Star Wars Action News, and Jedi Temple Archives to create this patch that's going to be available at different times. You could take the link here in the show notes once we post it, or just go to yakface.com or any one of the sites here involved, and there's a link as far as show or scheduled times where each individual patch will be available. The image that's shown there, that's an uncut patch that we're going to have available later. But this will be divided up into six pieces, you know, our logo on each piece. And BB-8's head is one separate piece that you can read there and details on how to get that. But it's very cool. This is something we've been working on for a while. And it's a pretty sizable patch as well.
And it's... again, I think it's you've all got to be commended on the one, the design, two, the cost of it, which is all done by you guys. That you know, it's you're coughing up to do this. You're not getting paid to do it by Lucasfilm. It's a genuine fan run thing. So
these patches aren't cheap. You know, because once assembled, the thing makes the patch about, I would say, 10 inches round or is
that's
in
big.
Diameter. Yeah, so each pie piece is, you know, about 4 inches, you know, aside. So they're pretty sizable patches, and we have, you know, a couple hundred of each patch to give away, and we'll be selling complete sets at a later time. So for people that can't make all panels or whatever, we're offering ways to get those. Each of us are going to, you know, put them up for sale at the same time, so we're not, you know, trying to undercut each other or whatever. So there are ways to collect them all, but yeah, the cost that goes into making these patches and getting them all produced is significant, but we're giving them away and we're, you know, selling a few. So we did this at the previous celebration and we really enjoyed it. And the response was really positive for it. So we wanted to do it again.
That makes for a great original collective. And it's nice to see some of the sites coming together and pulling together that kind of, piece, but a really nice kind of unified approach to it. Very well done.
Yeah. Let's see. A couple more exclusives here that we're touching on this week. Think Geek dumped a bunch of exclusives earlier this week. They've got everything, again, from patches and pins. That's where you can get the Lando pat or Lando pin, where he's got his gold necklace. Some posters, some celebration patches. Pretty neat stuff.
I thought they were really well done, these posters. They just looked very cool, very Pulp Fiction of the days going by. But some great interpretation on images and stills of Star Wars that just beautifully illustrated and drawn or touched up photographs, whatever they've done. But yeah, love it. The corners, very nicely done.
Yeah,
these pins, man. These pins are good. I thought the Star Tots were going to be hard, but nope. The pins are going to be the hard ones to get. So,
yeah, because they're only, what, 20 Star Tots. They're 96 pins, I think. Let's see what else. The last celebration exclusive here this week was something I had discovered yesterday when I received my issue of the Star Wars Insider. In the mail. This was on this was in the section and towards the back, and it's the R2KT version of R2D2, that's going to be available as a Hot Wheels collector car.
Which is very cool, nice. And for a good cause, too. So, yeah, Disney Mattel will be donating some of the proceeds to Star Wars Force for Change. So buy one, even if you don't want it. It's helping some kids and other people out. So
I definitely want it.
It's, nice car art as well. It's a beautiful. I love that figure. It's always
great.
Cool.
$10 is all it costs, and like they said, a portion of it goes to the Force for Change thing. So good deal all around for everyone.
Do some good.
Let's see. That brings us to TV, movie, book, and game news. The big news of the week was the release and official confirmation from Lucasfilm and Disney that the digital movie collection was available on the 10th. I think you and I had talked about this recently, even on last show, about, you know, do people really need this? What's different? You know, is it worth it? I guess it all depends on your point of view. Is it worth it? You know, if you don't have the Blu-ray, then it's obviously worth it. If you didn't pick that up, there's a lot of the same type of bonus features that were on there, and some new ones. They created, you know, obviously they do that. They create some new content to try to get some additional sales. But some pretty cool stuff on here. Different platforms that it's available: iTunes, Google, Vudu, Amazon. They just added the Verizon one that wasn't on there before.
I guess they wanted to be included. I mean, so I've never heard of Fios before, but never mind. It's nice to see. One thing is nice. I mean, in the past, we have it very selective, and I do applaud them for this, is having choice. They've given a ton of platforms and choice, which is a really nice thing. In the past, it's just been iTunes, which is a little limited, I think, for some people. But, you know, they've tried everything here to get it for everybody, so well done on that front, that's for sure.
So, yeah, and this was a global release too, so you're not limited by region, you know, like you are with, you know, Blu-ray or even, you know, Netflix. You know, if you release it that way, you know, some people are still waiting for, you know, the Clone Wars to show up in completion.
Yeah,
on Netflix. True, right? So, I didn't pick this up. I did pick up The Empire Strikes Back out of morbid curiosity. Because I wanted, there was rumors of changes. We didn't share this in the show notes, but there was a rumor that they were changing the Han shot first scene in A New Hope to change it back, at least in some regard, to actually make him shoot first instead of having Greedo shoot. That was debunked within an hour of that whole rumor going up. So, someone, I think it was Dark Horizons website. They're in Australia, and they were able to get that a day ahead, essentially, of where we are. And they shot that down quickly. So I knew I didn't need to get that to try to confirm or deny that rumor. But I do love Empire Strikes Back. And so I picked up that. Yes. And I was also curious, as it was rumored that the fanfare, you know, the Fox logo at the beginning, mm-hmm. the 20th Century Fox was changed or removed altogether. And I shared a video on YouTube in the wee hours of the night that day. And surprisingly, that hit, like, I think it's at like 7,000 or 8,000 views now, which is kind of surprising for just that small little teaser of a thing. But they did replace the 20th Century Fox fanfare with John Williams accompanied version of the Lucasfilm logo.
So yeah, goodbye 20th Century Fox. That's it, folks.
So that is on all of the movies except for A New Hope, which still has the 20th Century Fox because they own the distribution for that movie outright.
Can't see them giving that up in a hurry, but...
No.
Yeah, which caused some complications, I think, for people who wanted to watch. And I'm sure there wasn't that many people, but Disney Movies Anywhere, where A New Hope's not in the bundle. So
right. It's kind of funny, too. You see that, you know, through Twitter or social media, you see posts from Disney advertising, Star Wars is available on our platform. It's like, well, not really. You know, there's no caveat there that's saying that you're not getting a New Hope. It's kind of funny, but So
yeah. So
anyway, speaking of movies, at Celebration here in just a few short days, they Collider.com was confirming a rumor and speculation that there is in fact a Force Awakens trailer showing up on Thursday, as well as the poster is set to premiere at the kickoff event with J.J. Abrams and Kathleen Kennedy and whoever else is going to be in attendance for that start of the show. So,
I mean, it's to be expected, and it's definitely what a great way to start a Celebration is the anticipation of the Force Awakens finally getting to big trailers to show if that's what they do.
Yep.
So, yeah, looking forward to that very much.
Very much. Let's see, Celebration also, we're getting the debut of a unfinished, but, you know, it's from a story standpoint, it is complete, an unreleased Clone Wars arc titled Bad Batch. It's going to be presented in a similar way to how the Utapau arc was revealed or shown off, debuted on the StarWars.com websites, where it's all storyboard, you know, rough animatics, but it's got full audio as far as voiceover and whatnot. So I'm looking forward to this as well.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's again, we were talking about last night on the Wolfpack, it's just, and those guys are Clone Wars fanatics. They love it, and absolutely right. I mean, we're going to get to see Rex again, which is phenomenal.
Echo. Rex and Echo. Yep.
Yeah, just a little bit of closure on some of these characters would be nice. So, yeah, looking forward to that. Dave Filoni with some Q&A. It's, yeah, it's... New Star Wars anything is always good.
Yeah. Let's see, a couple other things here. This one caught my attention quite a bit. The Star Wars Collector's Archive had posted this, the Vader case project, where they're taking, you know, several different artists are taking the old vintage Darth Vader carrying case, and they're painting it up, similar to how they had done the helmets for Celebration 6. There was the Vader helmet project. This is the Vader case project. Yeah. Lots of cool, very inspired designs painted on those.
I know. Walking carpet, green Wookiee. So there's some bizarre ones on here. Just incredibly creative. Didn't even see that one before. Nice. So, yeah, it's just, I'm flicking through them just now if you're watching the video version of the show.
Yep.
But Skeletor, I guess, going on there. Luke burning his dad. They'd have added some more photographs. This is crazy. It's just, yeah. There's just some incredibly bizarre ones going on in here. But the beautiful one, I think you and I both just, I mean, look at the detail of that thing. The
Death
Star.
It's great.
Oh, wow. But I think you and I really just, I think that trumped us both.
Was, that one is magnificent.
It is. It's just Hildebrandt, gorgeous classic painting, just looking awesome. I can't believe this is on a carry case. Made me want to go and buy one, but then I thought I would never be able to recreate this. So what's the point? But yeah, Hasbro re-released this with this cover. You'll have plenty of sales, that's for sure. Don't know quite what that one was. Don't know.
Yeah, that one's kind of like I don't know what it is. It's like Beetlejuice.
I thought that with the black and white. Yeah, wow.
It's pretty cool.
And there we go.
This one was a favorite of mine as well.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. So there's tons of them. Check the link in the show notes and yeah, look for these great Vader project cases.
There was one also that wasn't shared in that particular gallery. There was a Macquarie Darth Vader version. I think I had shared that on the Yakfi Facebook page. Pretty cool. It's the, you know, the original Macquarie design of Vader's helmet in this style, you know, that's with the cool kind of purpley blue look. It's, that was one of my favorite ones as well.
I hope they do them in the same way that, I don't know whether you remember the Vader project, the way they laid, you could really get a chance to walk around them and see them. And so, yeah, I hope they get to read these off.
The next couple were ones that I had seen you share. Gus and Duncan Gus Lopez, Duncan Jenkins have a new book coming out. This is called The Guide to the Micro Collection. This is from the original Kenner release. Pretty cool to get a new book like this from them.
Exactly, and to then get the colleague, I'll just share the note here. The one of their colleagues, it was also on their blog. That's where I saw it. The proof, Kenner proof book, but the micro collection one is I love the packaging of the micro collection. So getting a chance to see some of that and some of the history behind it will definitely be something pretty good. And the other one they had, once we get this link load, was Matthias Randall, who's been a Celebration stalwart for many years. He's been there many times, did some great talks and presentations, and his book is A New Proof. So all about Kenner packaging, and I love that cover, just beautifully done there with a little
awesome
sticker, which we'll refer to later on, but nicely done with the Ken logo, and yeah, I immediately ran out and bought this, I think, as did you.
Yep, I did.
So yeah, if you wanted to buy it and pick it up at Celebration, it is now sold out in that way, but I would definitely buy one from their website, because you can buy one, and it's really low-cost shipping. So worldwide shipping for one or two books, $15. That's incredibly good, so no excuse for shipping charges. Go and buy one. This is a great book if you're a vintage fan. So, plus, there's a little notes written there by Ray. I wouldn't kill his surname, Persis or whatever. Ray, the art director at the firm who made the iconic designs for Kenner Star Wars in the first place. So, yeah,
yep.
Cannot wait to get this thing. Anyway, interesting.
Looking forward very much to getting that. Moving on to a little bit of comic news here. Darth Vader number 4 was released on Wednesday of this week. I was able to pick up my digital copy. Again, it's a pretty decent story going so far. I've liked it. This time, Darth Vader goes back to Geonosis to try to get a battle droid army going on his side.
I'm still on number 3, which I thought was great, actually. I was very impressed with the third issue. I finished that the other night. So, yeah, it's kind of an interesting story. I think it was actually pretty well done. I was really enjoying the story more, I would say, than Princess Leia.
Yep. Since you're just on issue number 3, hit the two droids that kind of debuted there, the 000, which is the protocol droid, which looks like a black chrome C-3PO, and there's an astromech as well, BT something. They're just as psychotic in the episode or in the issue number 4. The dialogue is really great with them. I think they're the most strongest characters in this arc so far, this episode or this issue. So
I like one panel in issue 3 where literally the little R2 unit looks like it looks like War Machine from Iron Man. Just all these guns and turrets.
He uses those in this new issue, so you get to see those guns in action.
Excellent.
Pretty cool. This one interested us both again, I think, pretty heavily. There is another version of the Star Wars number 4. Action figure variant cover. This one is Boba Fett. The same issue has the Chewbacca variant as well, but this is going to be available. It's rumored to be available at C2E2, but if you can't make that or whatnot, it was up for pre-order on the artist's website for $30.
Which was phenomenal. I was getting so depressed this thing was going to be a C2E2 exclusive. I just thought, oh, this is going to cost a fortune. And it was. People were happily spending, I think on Thursday, I think it was, $85 on eBay. Like 5 or 6 orders I saw pass by right in front of me. And I thought, ugh, $85 for a copy. I mean, why choose Boba Fett as the one to limit?
I know.
I don't know. Pick the Death Squad Commander or something. I don't know. Just insane. So, but thankfully, John Tyler Christopher put it onto his website, and man, did that thing sell out quick. I think literally within 18 hours or something, all gone.
Something like that. All 5,000 copies.
All 5,000 copies.
You bought one. I bought one.
I bought several.
Oh, well.
But I had to. So, yes. But beautiful cover. And again, I guess this is going to keep going. But just a little update. If you want to... They're a sponsor, but we both bought from them. If you, the newest issue, number 6, I think, is one of the ones that you can pre-order from MidtownComics.com. It's only $3. It's literally $3 to pre-advance the action figure variant cover. So, again, pre-ordering these things sometimes can save you a crap ton of money. So I would definitely go on. If you want to keep collecting them, and I know a lot of people are suddenly coming out the woodwork saying, oh, these are kind of cool. I really want to... Oh, no, I'm not going to spend that amount of money on them. So, yeah, definitely pre-order them. So check that one out. But number 5 still isn't quite available yet. I don't know why.
Yeah.
But 6 is out to order.
Let's see. Last bit of comic news here is that the Princess Leia series allowed Marvel to take the top 9 spots in comic sales for March, which is surprising, actually. You know, I think you and I both agree that the Princess Leia series isn't the strongest Marvel Star Wars line that's come out, but it's impressive that that many Star Wars titles are part of that sales group for March. Yeah.
It's well done. I mean, again, you and I didn't really like the story, I think, all that much. But, yeah, that's phenomenal. So, well done. Jeez, just showed you. Again, first issues sometimes, you know, you got to see how the run goes after it. But yeah, Princess Leia, number 1. Very cool.
Let's see, that brings us to the next one. I had posted on Twitter the other day the reveal of the badges that I'm hoping to hand out at Celebration next, or in a few days. This is the kind of the continuation of the badge that I had for C6. It's kind of a similar style, but it's the it's my own Marvel action figure variant cover for my badge, and there it is there, and it's a little glory there.
It's I love it. I absolutely love it. It's beautifully done the way you've done it and designed it, and just and compressed almost the look of the Yak Face figure there in the package. So really well done. And there's a little flag I mentioned in there too. Very cool. Realm recap, little flash. Very cool.
Had to throw some Realm Recap on there, yeah. Yeah, it says, watch us on the Realm Recap with Fly Guy Weekly on YouTube.
That's an awesome-looking cover. So what size is that, E5, I take it?
It's about, I think it's...
Postcard size?
What I'm showing there, that one's a little bit larger than the actual badges are going to be, but that is the design. The one I'm holding there, that's about 4x6.
That's big, dude.
Yeah, so the badge will be a little bit smaller. It'll be like 3x5 once it's, you know, once it's all laminated and whatnot. But it'll have, like I did last year, I've got one of those punches that does the traditional, you know, hang tag punch deal. So, kind of fun.
That's phenomenal. You actually have that. Okay.
Yeah. And it's funny, too, Marjorie from Star Wars Action News asked me a couple weeks ago where I got that, because their badges this year have that punch on them as well, because I had my that's what I had on my badge last year, or at last Celebration. So it's kind of funny.
I like it.
Yeah, so that was
a really cool collectible. Well, I'll be queuing up first when I see you. I'll be like, I want one. That's the really nice.
You've got one. You don't have to queue. You'll get one. Yes.
I'll be fighting them off. Get it.
These are going to be more limited, just like the comics are, and just like my badges last, there were only 250 for Celebration 6. There are only 100 of these.
Whoa. So, I think it's a very cool collectible. Anyway.
Thanks. I got a kick out of doing it again this year. So,
one more thing I think we'll go.
One more thing. This was just a little thing I was working on today. My kids and I, it was nice here for once in Minnesota as far as the weather goes, you know, not raining, snowing, or windy as hell. I took the kids out in the backyard, got the, you know, chalk out, and started illustrating on the on the patio of nice little picture of Chopper for them. I don't know if you were sharing that. There it is.
Yeah, it's just taking its time to pull through. It's a little slow tonight. But yeah. Two little very happy girls drawing Chopper. I think Daddy maybe had something to do with that.
I might have helped. Yeah.
That's cool. It's a very Jake-like style, I must say. You've got nice, cool graffiti kind of like work there. He's got some competition.
Yeah, I tried. We'll see if it's there in the morning. Sad face. Let's see. That brings us to our...
You really, I think, for some of your Star Wars work. But never mind. You should get Parent of the Year for all your Star Wars parenting that you're giving these kids.
I try. The girls that were there in the picture, they're into Star Wars Rebels. They know who the characters are in that. They have no idea who Luke Skywalker is. They don't have no idea who Darth Vader is, really. They know the Rebels characters, which is fine. Got to get them introduced somehow. My twins that we have, they weren't in the shot there, but they're 18 months old. They totally know who Chopper is. They grumble around. They'll do that. And they'll Chopper, chop, chop. They'll say that. So we're slowly but surely introducing them into the Star Wars world.
I don't think they have a choice.
No,
they have to, whether they like it or not.
By force.
Cool.
New toy reviews this week. I didn't have any. Did you have any this week?
No, not at all.
I've received a ton of stuff. I just, with Celebration coming up, I haven't had time to sit down and do anything really, but we did, both of us, get some stuff from our mailman, I would say, this week.
We did. I picked up from Dark Side Toys the Marvel Select Venom, one of the last ones, actually. They sold out really quickly. A great Marvel figure if you haven't seen him before. I thought it was going to be a repaint of Venom if you haven't seen that figure, which was a great figure as well. This is completely new, so very hard to get, very limited, and sadly, with a lot of Marvel Select, the quantities are always allocated, so they're very difficult to get sometimes. But he's a beauty, and that's the only real thing I got this week. I got a few other bits and pieces, but nothing. I think we talked about most of it last week, so no, that was me. What about you? You get some good stuff.
I got a bunch of stuff. Some of it I'm not even going to share. There's some stacks of boxes over there, those Hasbro boxes. Those are ones I have yet to go through. A lot of cases of Mission Series, Saga Legends, some 6-inch stuff. Most notably, I did pull out some of the highlights though from the week. Did I share this on last week's show?
I talked about it,
but I did get it in the mail. This is the vintage Kenner Yoda Empire Strikes Back final carrying case.
I was going to say lunchbox, but it's not. It was the figure carrying case. That's right.
Very good condition. No split vinyl, no cracks or splits. What's cool about the inside? It's got a half-used sheet of the labels, so I've got some on there. Yoda's name is on there. You can see it right there.
So you can.
So, happy about that. It's got the cool little card insert that has...
Worth it for that alone.
Yep, I love that. And then it's got the gray kind of beige trays that are in there, two of those.
Plastic.
So, one of my vintage scores for the week, which I like quite a bit.
Nice.
What else? I got the case of the new Black Series Deluxe Wave of Han Solo, which comes, you get two of these per case along with a repack of the Biker Scout. I think I'm good on Biker Scouts and Speeder Bikes. I have a lot. But that was a good one this week, as well as... Bosk and Han with the Stormtrooper outfit disguise. That Bosk is awesome. I'm looking forward to opening those. What else? I got this. I was curious, again, kind of one of those morbid curiosity kind of things. I was interested to see how Bandai, their scale of model kits were, because these are supposed to be, 1/12 scale, roughly 6-inch scale. Models of R2-D2 and R5-D4. There's no paint or no glue involved in putting these together, but there are a ton of pieces.
And it's, yeah, there's no glue. It's just a snap together and stickers. And
yeah, it's snap, but there, I don't even know how many pieces there are. I don't know if it says on the box. I didn't even look. I just opened it up. But it is insane the number of parts that are available in this set to build your two Astromechs. I'm looking.
You and I are, and I think certainly in the West here, these kits are relatively new to us, but in Australia and certainly in Asia, where I've ever been, they're really, really popular for all sorts of stuff like Gundam and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, expect to see more of them, I would imagine. So,
yeah. I don't know when I'm going to have time to put these together.
We'll need a week.
Yeah. In May, my wife is going on vacation with half of our kids to Florida, so I'll be at home with the other two, and that might give me some time, you know, after they go to bed. I'll spread them out on the kitchen table and go to work one night and see if I could get one done.
Nice.
Like I said, there's no glue or paint needed, so I think I might be able to knock one out in a night. What else? This... I'll just show these as a group because I've showed one of these before, the Darth Vader Revo set from Kaedo. I did get the.
Oh, I think we've just lost your audio. I think maybe.
Have we? Here we go.
Oh, you're back.
Back. Here are the other three that are available in this set: the Stormtrooper, R2-D2, C-3PO. These look fantastic. The C-3PO is. The glare kind of sucks here, but the detail is really, really spot on for him.
Yep.
There goes, who was that? That was Vader, decided to take a swan dive off the table. Stormtrooper again, a lot thinner, skinnier than the Hasbro version.
Yep.
So I'm interested to see how this fares in comparison. And then the R2-D2.
He looked pretty
again. The scale is pretty much the same as that R2-D2. I think this might be a little bit bigger. I haven't taken them out side by side yet, but I look forward to checking these out because the packaging for one thing is just fantastic.
It's really nice, yeah. The shipping containers alone are collectible. There's just the cool writing and Star Wars Revo on it. They're beautiful.
Yeah, like in comparison, here's the Black Series Han with Tauntaun, you know, nothing on the end. You know, you can barely make out what's on the back. With the Revoltech stuff, you know, you get nice full color images on the end caps. You know, the top has got text, the bottom has got stuff.
Yep.
It's just the presentation really, you know, being in graphic design and whatnot, it really helps to sell the piece as a unit versus
price point. They're not really compatible in some ways,
right?
Anyway,
$50 versus 20, but
yeah,
the packaging does help. Oh, that's it, I think, for me this week as far as oh no, I have one more thing.
Is that all? I'm kidding.
I have a little. This is Groot that my sister-in-law she crocheted this.
Wow,
it is pretty awesome. It's got a little pot. And he's got little bendy arms.
That's insane. That's really cool.
I had to show that off because she had posted that she crochets a bunch of stuff, you know, different animals and whatnot. And she did a Groot, and I saw it on Facebook, and I'm like, I want that. And so she made me one. So he's got his little leaves on there, and
she needs an Etsy store if she doesn't have one.
She's working on it.
That's very cool. I'm very impressed.
It's very cool, and. Because I'm going to Celebration, you know, that takes some funds to go. I didn't want my wife to feel left out, so I got her one of those damn Apple Watches. That was my purchases for the week.
Your purchase for the week.
Yeah, so.
I'm sure I'll have to make a penalty to my wife for the time I'm away as well. So.
Yeah, I'm not hearing the end of it, really. So.
Very cool.
Anyway, I think with that is this week's show. Again, we'd like to thank everyone for watching and sharing and commenting on our previous shows. We will be off next week because it's Celebration. So we're not going to try to cram in a show. There'll be way too much going on, and we'll probably be
exhausted
or under the weather. Who knows? We might have the
adult beverages,
booze flu. We'll see. But we will be back in at least 2 weeks to recap everything that had gone on at Celebration.
That's going to be a moment of
amazing things. So, again, we will be back in 2 weeks. And thanks, everyone, for watching.
Adios.
Adios.